দর্শক আমন্ত্রণ জানাচ্ছি আন্তর্জাতিক সম্পর্ক উন্নয়ন বিষয়ক আরটিভির বিশেষ অনুষ্ঠান ডিপ্লোম্যাটিক জোনে। আপনাদের সঙ্গে আছি আমি নবিলা হাসান। আমাদের আজকের অতিথি ইউএনএইডস এর বাংলাদেশ প্রতিনিধি লিও কেনি। ভেরি ওয়েলকাম এট ডিপ্লোম্যাটিক জোন।
থ্যাংক ইউ নবিলা, এন্ড মে আই সে আই ওয়ান্টেড টু কংগ্রাচুলেট আরটিভি অন দ্য 9th অ্যানিভার্সারি, এন্ড বাট পার্টিকুলারলি বিকজ আই থিংক দ্যাট ইউভ শোন a great interest in addressing HIV AIDS, and we thank you very much for that. That shows great community spirit.
It is our opportunity as well. So tell us something about UNAIDS.
Well, we are a joint program. Mm-hmm. We have 11 co-sponsors. The newest co-sponsor is UN Women.
UN Women.
Which tells you a little bit about how important gender equality is. And the usual range of suspects from WHO, UNICEF, UNFPA, WHO, FAO, and etc.
Okay, so at this moment, what is your top priority?
The global goal, the vision that we've tried to lay out, is called the three zeros. And that means we ask every country to think about how you can get to zero new infections, and zero AIDS-related deaths, and zero discrimination. So that's the encompassing goal. You know, interestingly, a lot of people are saying, well, that's impossible. Well, sure, it's an aspirational goal, but certainly what we would like to see is how we can assist countries and governments and civil society in thinking about what do you actually have to do to make sure you're getting to those zero new infections.
Last year we celebrate a World AIDS Day. So data says that last year 82 actually dies due to AIDS, and new case detect 370. So what's your opinion actually?
Well, you know, globally we've seen great strides in addressing new infections. And you know, since 2001 there's been a 30% reduction in the number of new infections. So globally last year, I think there were around about 2.3 million new infections. Now, what is of great concern is that although Bangladesh did a very good job in addressing this epidemic early, and it's a great credit to the Minister of Health and the government, although they addressed it by getting and making targeted high impact interventions, particularly around people who are injecting drugs, sex work, etc. Although that was done, Bangladesh is in fact one of the three or four countries in Asia Pacific where that 33% reduction has not been seen. In fact, you just mentioned that there were 370 new infections last year. That relates to about a 20% increase. So it's going the wrong way. It's going the wrong way. It's going the wrong way.
So what are the measurements we must take to reduce this rate actually?
We know how to prevent infections and we know how to treat them. With the new treatment available, an opinion piece in the paper saying that we feel that if we roll out this treatment 2015, according to the new guidelines on WHO, it requires us to make sure that people are getting treatment earlier. And that would double the number of people who need to be on treatment. You know, at the moment, Bangladesh has done a very good job in making available antiretroviral treatment to everybody who needs it. But the problem is, Navila, that we're only detecting around a third of the estimated cases. So we talk about the cumulative number of HIV infections, that's all the infections put together, around 3,200. But we estimate, and we do these estimates by putting data into a progressive model which looks at the estimated number of people living with HIV, and that's over 8,000, between 8 and 12,000 people. So we're only detecting about a third of the cases. People who were detected had been overseas. Now, we in no way want to stigmatize migrants, but we need to be doing much more to make sure that migration is safe. So we need to reach these people with prevention measures before they go overseas. We need to make sure we're protecting them when they're overseas, and we need to reach them when they come back. So, but you know, the migration area, although it forms a high percentage of new infections, it's somewhat of a cul-de-sac. It's probably not the area in which you might see an explosion of this epidemic. That will probably be when these bridging populations between people who inject drugs and sex work and et cetera, when that gets out of control into the general public, that's where you see an explosion in the epidemics in other countries.
So I think awareness is very important. So is there should be any kind of like, as you mentioned, any class or counseling, thus they are aware of this thing and like keep them aside from those people. Is there any steps, do you think?
Yes, you know, a lot of work using the Global Fund on AIDS, TB and Malaria and donor partners funds through the so-called HPNSDP, it's called the program in health. A lot of work has been done on awareness, and a lot of work, and I think what is really key is young people.
Young people, yes. You were talking about reproductive health, so HIV-related maternal deaths are now concern, a big concern actually. So what actually UNAIDS and other organizations doing for this?
We think that, well, we don't think, we know, that Bangladesh has done a very good job on the Millennium Development Goals related to maternal and child health. Some of the best results in the world, actually. So that's tremendous. We have also done, I think, you know, a very robust response on HIV. So that's a real credit to Bangladesh. Where we probably don't see enough attention yet is where, you know, I was talking to you before about HIV testing not going to scale. Well, here's some ways to make it go to scale. Make sure that every service that offers neonatal, postnatal, any maternal child health services, make sure that all TB services, make sure that sexual reproductive health services, make sure these things are integrated. Instead of having one service for MCH, another for TB, another for malaria, another for HIV.
Altogether, actually,
if
has
you
to
can,
be done.
Yes, and so that way, I think it's an economy of scale where you can actually use those services. The other very important thing is to, you know, it was interesting, I was talking to my local general practitioner, and I asked him, you know, how many cases did he see of new HIV infections? This is Dr. Wahab. Hello, Dr. Wahab. you know, whilst he said there weren't that many, these are not being reported. Now, if we think that there's approximately 70,000 general practitioners across the country, then these levels remain low, and this is being called a functional cure. It's not a cure, but it's certainly great strides have been made because of people who are being treated now.
So what do you think, like what role should play the National AIDS Committee?
Well, the National AIDS Program has had tremendous, you've been very lucky in Bangladesh, and this is leadership from the top. You know, the minister himself and the Ministry of Health and a whole range of, there's a multi-sectoral forum of inter-ministerial commission on HIV. So that's showing great commitment. The National AIDS Program, STD and AIDS Program, has had very good leadership from a line director by the name of Dr. Wahid. he has just retired, actually, and we welcome Dr. Mm-hmm. Khan, who is the new line director, who's just taking over. So this kind of leadership is really critical to the response. And I think that the government of Bangladesh has done a good job in this respect.
So I want to mention that UNAIDS spent more than $100 million for different organizations. Mm. For this kind of activities. But do you think these NGOs are transparent enough? Actually, they are spending in a right way.
Mm.
What do you think?
Well, first of all, UNAIDS doesn't spend that money. We are really there to ensure that these resources are available. You know, in Bangladesh over the last 10 years, the Global Fund on AIDS, TB and Malaria mm-hmm. has made available over $370 million. For AIDS, TB and malaria. Now that's a massive whack. So it's really critical that we ensure that those resources are reported upon, that they are transparent and accountable, that the agencies who are, and the NGOs and who are implementing this money are transparent and accountable. The Global Fund particularly, I think, is very strong on accountability, performance-based, and that's a very good thing. So it's absolutely critical that civil society and government can show this transparency and accountability. And we work very closely with them to do that, and I think that we're moving in the right direction. Mm-hmm. The most important thing to remember is that these resources are to save people's lives.
Yes, definitely.
And to prevent new infection. So, you know, there's no excuse for any kind of corruption in this field.
Okay, we will talk more on some other issues after a short break. দর্শক দেখছেন আন্তর্জাতিক সম্পর্ক উন্নয়ন বিষয়ক অনুষ্ঠান ডিপ্লোম্যাটিক জোন। এই পর্যায়ে নিচ্ছি বিরতি, ফিরছি একটু পরে, সে পর্যন্ত আমাদের সঙ্গে থাকুন।